Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick coming to you. Hope you guys are doing all right. I don't even know where to begin, brothers and sisters. I really haven't made any videos because the Lord is, there's lots and lots of things the Lord shows me all the time that I don't make videos about. Anyway, the purpose of my YouTube ministry, brothers and sisters, has been to get people right with the Lord and get them rapture ready, to get the church rapture ready to go and meet at the church of the firstborn, as it tells us in Hebrews chapter 12, that we would be ready to go to Mount Zion and meet the Lord there in the air, to the church of the firstborn in heaven, brothers and sisters, after the rapture. Anyway, so I try to keep the focus on that. You know, I've done those videos in the past, about 21 videos or 22 videos of words for people. People ask me for words of wisdom, words of knowledge. And a lot of people saw it like a prophecy or whatever, but it's really words of wisdom and words of knowledge for people. I've done all that. I haven't seen anybody else doing that as far as I know. And praise God, you know, that the Lord gave me the anointing and the prophetic ministry to do those things. And anyhow, I don't want to get into all this theology of it. You know, there's five different offices in Ephesians 4:11. We see that. And I've talked about this many times, and I guess the Lord is just leading me to say this. There, any Christian who the Lord leads by the Holy Spirit, who is a Spirit-filled Christian, can get a word of wisdom, a word of knowledge, and or even a prophecy for edification of the church, as the Bible tells us. But then there's the offices, brothers and sisters, people who are preachers, elders in the church, who operate in one of the offices, of the five different offices we see in Ephesians 4:11. So it's people that are in these different offices, they usually operate in spiritual gifts that match that office, like an evangelist. Lots of times evangelists will operate in the gift of healing, as an example. Anyhow, prophetic people, someone is in the office of a prophet. It's words of wisdom, words of knowledge, and prophecies is the main area where God uses them. You know, it matches their office. And usually at a high, you know, at these different things, like there's lots of people, the gift of healing, different types of healing, the gifts of healing, as it says in this First Corinthians chapter 12, I'm referring to, but someone who's a healing evangelist, they usually have a whole lot more healings because they're dealing with a lot of people. And the signs and wonders follow the gospel. Anyway, why I'm talking about that. But anyway, brothers and sisters, the Lord has been giving me so many words, so many prophecies and things of what's going on. And I just wanted to talk about that. And, you know, I said that stuff first, number one, for the edification of the saints. The stuff I just said. And, you know, brothers and sisters, I want to say this. If it was up to me, I would prefer if people that run to and fro wouldn't watch my videos, who are date set, who are looking for a date of the rapture and all that. Me personally, if I could control who watches my videos, I prefer that people that are seeking salvation, seeking to go in the rapture, to know the Lord, to be used by God, to be discipled, those are the people that I would prefer to watch my videos, because that's who my videos are for. And that's why, brothers and sisters, I'll tell you, since, you know, the church age is basically over as soon as the rapture happens, and that's another word I got from the Lord. The church age is over. That's it. The Lord is setting the Father's, this is one of the words the Lord gave me, God is setting his face like flint to go to Jerusalem, to build up Jerusalem and Israel. Just like in the Bible, we see that Jesus' face was set like flint to go up to Jerusalem to accomplish the passion of the Christ, as it's called, to accomplish what God sent him, the Father sent him to do, which was to suffer under Pontius Pilate, to be, you know, to take the stripes for us to be healed and to be crucified and take upon himself our sins, to become sin for us. So the Father has set his face like flint to go up to Jerusalem because he wants to restore Israel, to graft back in the natural olive branches, as it says in Hebrews 9 and 11. The Lord is going to restore Israel, and God is focusing to work with Israel. That's one of the words I got from the Lord. But I just want to say this. I always put these nuggets from the Lord on purpose in the middle of my videos and mixed in. Because, you know, the words are for those who have an ear to hear, and it's for the God's people. It's not for people who are clowning around. You know, and that's why those nuggets are hidden. And that's why when you go dig for gold, you know, you have to find it. You know, you have to dig it out. And so I put them in my videos so that people who are watching my videos to be discipled, to seek the Lord, and all those kind of things, who are serious about the Lord, will hear those things that the Lord taught me. So, and I've mentioned this in a video a couple of times way, way back. So those of you who watch my videos, you know that's how I do it. And the Lord has been giving me so many words, brothers and sisters, it's not even funny. But I may make a separate video on this other one, and just a short video. But anyway, I just want to discuss something, things with you, and just mention, you know, as an example, I just saw, now the Lord didn't tell me, I read it on raptureready.com, that some of the things happened in September, if you haven't heard, that the Sanhedrin, which was reconstituted, another end time sign, the Sanhedrin was reconstituted after like 1,300 years. They're going to put Obama on trial, or they're going to try to, whatever, they're going to, I don't know if they're going to, you know, have some kind of, whatever, they're going to have a trial for Obama to find him, you know, they want to find him guilty of performing genocide on the nation of Israel by, you know, war crimes, I guess, or religious crime, you know, based with the Sanhedrin, for making this deal with Iran. That's going to be on the 13th of September that will begin. And on the 15th of September, probably the most important thing that's going to be going on is that the UN is going to have a two-day summit about a final solution for Israel to divide the land and all that. And guess what? Fleur-de-lis, as the Lord had given me the final road sign before the rapture, is the Fleur-de-lis. And France is going to be leading the way. And the other thing, and I'm going to make a separate video for each one of these, I guess. The other thing is that the Lord gave me another sign. This is a sign to Israel that it's time for, you know, the God of Israel to arise and let his enemies be scattered. A sign to Israel is Israel shall stand alone. And Israel right now, with this pact, that pact made with Iran, is really prophetic in the fact that it's, you know, once it goes to Congress. Now, the final date, I think it's also either, you know, the Congress has, is it 3 months or 6 months or whatever it is. And that's also September 13th or the 23rd, one of those days, is the final day in that same time period that, you know, the U.S. Congress has their window to approve or disapprove. It's 60 days, whatever it is. That's also in that same time period. It's one of those days too, brothers and sisters. So all of these things are coming again. The Lord's been giving me so many words, brothers and sisters. As I've mentioned, all of them just kind of scattered in this thing without a, you know, that's the Lord kind of a thing. But it really seems that this is really going to be it. The time is really up. I don't know what else to tell you, brothers and sisters. I just think the Lord, there's been, you know, 90% of the people that I've dealt with through the YouTube ministry have been great people. 10% of the people have been very painful. Very unbelievable stuff, brothers and sisters. And I thought about that too. I sometimes I think, you know, I would just love to make a video and just tell all the things that some people have done to me, you know, a servant of God, and all kinds of bizarre things. But, you know, I just give it to the Lord. The Lord knows. And so, I guess, you know, the theme of my videos a lot of times is basically to the church. You know, do what God's called you to do before the rapture, because you won't have another chance. This is it, you know. And stop, get off your blessed assurance and get out there and do what God called you to do. You know, there's tons of people God has called, you know, Christians to evangelize their neighbor, to give Bibles to the poor, to build orphanages in the Philippines, as an example, like what Joshua's ministry does. You know, do all those things, and you haven't done it. You know, I mean, Lord knows how many orphanages we could have built, or how many crusades we could have had, or how many things, you know, those kind of things we could have done if all the people were obedient to God to pray for Joshua's ministry, to donate to Joshua's ministry when God told them to whatever it may be, to pray for me, to pray for the ministry, to pray for the house parents. You know, who knows? And there's lots of people that in the church who are disobedient. The vast majority of people are disobedient to what God wants them to do, and not doing what God's will in their life. And that's what the judgment seat of Christ is all about. You know, we'll face the judgment seat of Christ, and then that's when, you know, we'll see if we have any crowns in heaven and rewards and all those things. We go through that process, the judgment seat of Christ, the bema seat of Christ, and it's coming. And the Bible says that we'll be ashamed there, you know, and all of our, what we thought were deeds, is we don't have any, passes through the fire, as the Bible says. It gets burned up. And we don't have anything. And there we are looking like a clown. You know, just like some of the trolls. Now, thank God, by the grace of God, those trolls don't move. They haven't moved me, but sometimes trolls have hindered people's ministries and stuff. And you know, on judgment day, when those trolls are standing there before the Lord and they're like, you know, what you've done to the least of these, my brethren, you've done it unto me. And then the Lord says, well, you know, this person who's one of my servants, who I commanded to make videos on YouTube to preach the gospel, and then you're mocking them and hindering them and sending insulting statements and backbiting them and bearing false witness against them. You know, and then you kept this person from making 25 videos, and out of that 25 videos, let's just say that, well, whatever, let's just say 20 people would have gotten saved that didn't get saved or didn't hear the gospel, whatever, I don't know. Can you imagine that? I don't even like to think about stuff like that, brothers and sisters, because it's going to be something else. That's all I can say. The judgment seat of Christ is we're going to be ashamed there. You know, and you know, all of us, none of us are perfect. There's no doubt. But you know, the Lord judges our works based on the motives of our heart, the intentions of our heart, what we're trying to do. And we all have to give an account to Him for every idle word, He said. We have to give an account. That's why the whole importance of repentance, even as Christians. All these greasy gracers, man, they're going to have a serious time up there in front of the Lord when they get up there and say, well, I said the sinner's prayer, and Jesus is going to say, well, what about in my word and 1 John 1:9, where I spoke through the Apostle John, and I said, you know, if we sin, we have an advocate with the Father, and that's verse 7, and then in verse 9 it says, if we confess our sins, because the letter of 1 John is written to the church. It says, if we, as in the church, if we confess our sins, He is just and faithful to forgive us of our sins and cleanse us of all unrighteousness. So if we don't confess our sins, then there seems to be some unrighteousness that's in us. You know, that would be what I deduce from the text. You know, I made that Sherlock Holmes deduction. It's pretty elementary, dear Watson, that if we confess our sins, He is just and faithful to forgive us and cleanse us of all unrighteousness. Then if we do not confess our sins, you know, it seems to be that we would still have unrighteousness in us. And so unconfessed sin in the Christian is going to be, it's going to spell, trouble at the judgment seat of Christ. Like 1 Corinthians chapter 3 is one of those passages that talks about that. Anyway, brothers and sisters, I'm pretty tired out. That's why I'm talking pretty like I am. The Lord has just shown me so many things, and I mentioned lots of them in this video, just in a normal conversation, because I've just been, you know, I've just been astonished at all the things the Lord's been showing me, let's put it that way. And you know, it's a lot of, like I said, in a lot of ways I don't feel like sharing them with those people that run to and fro. I've been rebuking them and rebuking them and rebuking those people, but you know, there are many of you, and you know who you are, who are steadfast Christians and mature in the faith and all that. Lots of you guys, so I make it for you guys, you know, for the truth seekers and those in the body of Christ who are seeking after the things of God. And I, you know, and that's why I'm doing it for you guys. And let's, you know, we've already prayed for these people, prayed for them and prayed for them, but now we hand them, I hand them over to God. Because, you know, time is up. And I mean, that's the, you know, the word, the Lord's telling me all these things, you know, the church age is over, it's finished, it's done, and the Lord has set his face to deal with Israel and all that. Just like I made a video when I was in the Philippines in like maybe February, March, somewhere in there, saying that I would start making more stuff focused toward Israel, and you know, that's the same, you know, the word that the Lord gave me at that time, but I haven't really executed it very well. But now the Lord is, you know, reminding me that again more clearly and strongly that it's church age is basically over with, you know, the falling away and all that stuff. And only people, you know, only those who are going to be, you know, that are lukewarm, that will still have, you know, repent before the rapture and go in the rapture, those are the only people that, you know, God is dealing with and God is reviving. If there are some left, I don't know. Maybe all the people that are, all the wise virgins are already set. I don't know that. You know, but that's the only thing God's dealing with, is those wise virgins as we are about to depart. And his focus is totally shifting over to Israel now. So, you know, all the things I've been hearing from the Lord is about Israel. A post-rapture, post-church age words I'm getting from God. I've got, a dozen different words from God, or I don't know how many, more than that maybe. All about the rebuilding of Israel and the post-rapture world. So, brothers and sisters, to the Gentile church, the wise virgins, praise God. We looks like we made it, you know. I'm just saying, it just came to my mind, that song by Shania Twain, which I haven't heard in years. It's, you know, look like we made it. Look how far we've come. You know, they said we're not going to make it, but we've made it. Looks like, brothers and sisters, that we've made it. So let's hold on, you know, for one more day. Let's hold on, brothers and sisters, until we get there with the Lord. Why am I, these secular songs are coming to mind. A lot of people maybe don't know that one. Hold on for one more day. I think it's Wilson Phillips. How do I remember the names of these groups? Must be from the Lord. But I guess we're almost out of here, brothers and sisters. So praise God. Praise God. God bless you all. And so I guess I need to make some short videos, you know, for the short bus people. Just little short videos about those words, you know. The sign for Israel is Israel stands alone. War of Gog and Magog is coming so that the world may know that there is a God in Israel. Ezekiel 38:39 is the text I'm referring to. This war of Gog and Magog. And then that's why God's going to do it, because the world will know that there is a God in Israel, and he will destroy 5 out of 6 of the Persian and the Russian army and all that, and all the allies there that attack Israel. So Israel stands alone, and that's the sign for them. And then the sign for the church, the final sign that I've been talking about for a couple of years, is the Florida Lee. And, you know, it's France. France is the one that's seems to be, that's going to ramrod this peace treaty, this covenant, the 7-year covenant, which is the mark of the beginning of the tribulation. And so I guess it's the Prime Minister of France or the King of France. Do they have some royalty there? Whatever, I don't know. You know, I've looked at it. It's been a long time. Anyway, brothers and sisters, God bless you all. And yes, I'm kind of, like I said, it's late at night. I'm tired, so I'm giving you the last two videos. I'm giving you my sitting in astonishment from the things the Lord showed me video personality here. This is me sitting in astonishment at all the things the Lord showed me. And just talking and just like a normal across the table conversation here, not under the, you know, preaching, you know. And that's the difference. I'm talking to you, not preaching. And that's the difference when the Holy Spirit is on you to, you know, like preaching is different. You know, teaching, preaching, and then just chit-chatting. This is a chit-chat. Anyway, brothers and sisters, God bless you guys. You know that I love and appreciate all of you guys. I mentioned a little bit of negative in there. But, you know, as I said in the beginning, 90% of the people that I talk to are really great people. Really been good to me. You know, that's been really friends to me in the Lord, brothers and sisters in Christ. And all the people that help with the You know, I mentioned too also that we're able to pay off another $20,000. Of course, it seems as if this all that's going to be for naught here, you know, because we're going to be out of here. But, you know, still going forward with that. Still have $20,000 left of debt out of 60. And I guess the original money that I put down, so it's nearly $70,000 for the orphanage number 3. And everything that goes along with that. But so down to 20,000 in just 4 months. So like 10,000 a month. So praise the Lord for that. It's been awesome. It's been awesome. And, you know, I've been thinking about whether I would, you know, I had some money invested that I'd borrowed against. I thought about selling it to pay off that last 20,000. And then, you know, I feel like the Lord just told me don't worry about it. And I'm not one of those people that is like that, you know. I'm not one of these people that sit around saying the rapture's tomorrow, the rapture's tomorrow, the rapture's tomorrow. You guys haven't heard me doing that like a lot of people or some people. You know, I've been going forward and ramrodding to do the will of God no matter what and not really sitting around dwelling on the rapture. You know, of course, I'm looking for the rapture but not dwelling on it or obsessed with it. But so I don't, you know, lightly run to and fro saying the rapture's tomorrow. And I'm not saying it's tomorrow, but it's... I believe this is the season. I believe, you know, that if they're going to make this, the tribulation is going to start in September. The rapture will be before that date, whatever the date of the peace treaty is. You know, so whatever. I believe it's all these blood moons. I mean, I've already talked about all this stuff. Anyway, brothers and sisters, God bless. I've already been rambling on more than 20 minutes. Anyway, brothers and sisters, God bless. I'll say it again. God bless you guys. You know that I love you guys and I appreciate you guys. I guess tomorrow I'll try to make a few fiery videos proclaiming the words that I gave already in this video from the Lord and some more that the Lord has given me, if I can get my mind straightened out here what all they are. But I asked Brother Gary. Brother Gary's been on the East Coast for the last few weeks. You know, I saw him. I asked him, you know, because we had prayed together about some of this stuff and the Lord had shown us different stuff and I can't remember what all. I got all these words from the Lord. I can't remember what all it was. And because we didn't record it. And so I asked Brother Gary when he's going to be getting back out there to Cali. He's going to be back in Cali. No longer anymore on Tulsa time. Now see, I've already heard two more songs in that sentence and don't know. I don't know why. But anyway, because I'm not listening to that music. But anyway, brothers and sisters. So Brother Gary, I asked him to make a few. Gary Bear, 049. I asked him to make a few videos and discuss the things that he remembers of the things that we heard from the Lord and all of that and his impression of it and the things the Lord showed him too. So we're just getting started. And I'm just touching on these things. And I told him I might even see if we can Skype and then make it where other people can see it. And I don't really know how we could do it other than Skype it and do that screen-o-matic, but it's only 15 minutes you can do, you know, unless you buy the professional version of that. So I don't know. And then trying to figure out a way what we can do. Some, I don't know if it's, what do they call it, Tiny Chat or whatever. Or we can go on there and have video and we could discuss these things. And then people could see it, you know, if that's what the Lord wants. Because there's so many things that the Lord showed us. I can't even remember 1/10 of it. But it's all kinds of awesome, cool stuff, brothers and sisters. Like I've just been talking about a few of the things I shared in this video. It's so awesome and so much cool stuff. And revelations that the Lord has been giving us. Illuminations of the Word is actually the right expression. Just to FYI, I mentioned it a long time ago. You know, people say a revelation from the Lord is like a new Bible verses. Illumination is God illuminated something from the Word to you. Just to FYI, you know. Because sometimes, you know, maybe someone's watching, you know, who knows these things. And they think you're saying you got a revelation from God. Anyway, brothers and sisters, God bless you. God bless you. Maybe this is the final time I'll say it. If it is, then I'll see you on the other side. But, you know, I'm kind of negative on it. I'm kind of negative on when the rapture will be. Because I just, when it happens, and that's just going to be it. God bless you guys.